Recently, Power BI added a new feature which makes it very easy for Excel users to move to Power BI. That is called on-object interaction. This feature was added in March 2023, so make sure you have the latest version of Power BI Desktop. You'll have to enable this feature first. So go to File, Options and Settings, Options, Preview Features, scroll down and then enable on-object interaction. You'll have to restart Power BI for this to take effect. Now let's see this in action. First of all, we need some data. So I'm going to start with the sample data set. Load sample data. We want the financials table and click on the load button. Now the data goes into the data tab and we have a blank report page. In the report page itself, we have the data section where we can open this table and see all the columns. The visuals dropdown is there in the home tab as well as in the insert menu. Now you'll notice that in Excel as well, we have insert and various types of charts. So now it's very similar to Excel. Now let's finally add a visual. You can click on the new visual button or you can right click anywhere on the screen and say add visuals. Here I click on this add data button and there is an add data well or area where you can drag drop. So I'm going to drag and drop product here. As soon as I do that, it shows me something. It's like a table and it is also suggesting which visuals will be suitable for this. Right now we have only one column which is of type text. Now let me add gross sales and see what happens. The suggested types changed and now it's giving me different types of visuals. Now of course if I open this dropdown, I get to see all the visuals, but by default what is it doing? It is suggesting a type of chart based on what kind of data, columns or fields or dimensions you are adding to this visual. So this is how you create a visual. Just for practice, let's add one more. Again, right click, say add visual. And this time we will add something which has both as numbers. Add gross sales and discounts. Because these are just two numbers, it has summed them, which is the default summarization. And it is showing it to me in a visual called multi-row card. I'm going to put something which is text. Let's go with product. So now, what is it showing? Things which work numeric to numeric on x-axis and y-axis, which is a scatter chart. In addition to that, it's also showing me a standard chart, which is showing me discount and gross sales side by side or in a stacked manner, either horizontally or vertically. In Excel as well, we have something called recommended charts. And depending on which data you have chosen, it actually shows or suggests the most suitable charts for your data. And that's exactly what it is doing. Earlier, we had to drag drop data from the field list into the well. I can still do that, but that's not really required. When you click on add data button, this list directly appears here, which is so much easier, more convenient and less confusing. So let's create a simple visual, product, segment and gross sales. Fine. Now, if I want to change any of those items, just click on this arrow. The same field list appears again and I can change it very quickly from here itself. Now, if you have never seen Power BI before, probably you have not even understood what is the great deal of this new feature. Let me remind you, this is how Power BI works. The list of visuals is shown here in a bunch. There is nothing in insert menu. There is nothing in home tab. And if you wanted to create a visual, you choose the visual. And then these field wells, as we call them, appear here, nowhere near the visual. And then you drag drop from the list directly here. Now that was about creating visuals, but the real confusion comes later. I already have a chart or a visual. Now I want to change the color of this from blue to something else. In Excel, what would you naturally do? Right click on it and choose format. But here it doesn't work that way. In right click, you don't get format option at all. You have to click on the visual. Then this is the visuals area. The next one is the format area. And now you get a very long list of things. Notice when I open each one of them and it goes on and on and on. Yes, you can search. But if you don't know what exactly you're searching for, it is laborious and confusing. Let's see what happens with the on object interaction turned on. First thing you will notice that I have put two visuals because I want to show how the cross filtering is affected when we are doing the formatting part. The second thing you should notice is yes, we do have the field list, but Even when you click on the visual, there is no formatting area shown at all. So how do you do formatting? Oh, there are two ways of doing it. One is this icon, which is very similar to what we get in Excel. And exactly like what we get in Excel, we have all the components of a chart or a visual, and then you can enable or disable them. So for example, I want data labels, one click and it's done. I don't have to go into that confusing long list of formatting options at all. But in case I want further refinement, by all means, I can go to more options. And then the same formatting options like before do appear here. Now notice what happens when I click on the chart, the format pane will show the chart formatting. But the moment I right click, and this is where on object interaction is coming into play. The moment I right click and choose format, this becomes a blue border. What does that mean? Now I am in formatting mode. So now if I click on the chart, it's not going to filter anything. It's not in cross filter mode at all. Now it's in formatting mode. Now when I click on this, the correct part of the formatting area crawled into view. Similarly, if I click on the axis, that part expands automatically and comes into view. The features are coming to you rather than you running behind features. Now that is called object interaction. Now how do you come out of this blue thing? Oh, you click outside. So now it's a regular black border. It's no longer in formatting mode. So now when you click on a visual, it'll cross filter as expected. So that is the beauty and the benefit of on object interaction. I'm sure you found this useful. So please like, share, subscribe. Most importantly, put your comments and queries. I'll be happy to answer them. If you're new to Power BI, I have a beginner tutorial which is really popular. Have a look at it. That's it for now. Thank you.